Located in a picturesque setting by the river Ganges, the Patna College has been imparting higher education since its establishment on 9th January 1863. For many generations in the eastern part of India and Nepal, Patna College has not been merely an institution where they spent a few years of their youth, but a living tradition of which they form a part. In fact, the history of Patna College has been the history of growth and development of higher education in this region.
This is the college which is the oldest college in eastern India after Presidency College, Calcutta. This building is a Dutch building. Records suggest this building was constructed around 400 years ago.
In good old days, it indeed used to be perhaps one of the most important centers of learning in North India. The only universities which would compete with it or excel it were the Calcutta University and in some departments Allahabad University.
Patna College has been a very pleasant experience in life. I had wonderful friends, very good teachers, faculties, and after studying there I really believed that it is Oxford of the East without competition of a Cambridge.
Patna College had a very important academic identity. The teachers were committed. The teachers felt pride in being professor of a Patna College. Students felt pride of being a student of Patna College. There was a complete sense of ownership.
It is hard to believe that the site of an opium godown went on to house a premier institution of higher education in India. Indeed, it is the fifth oldest college in India. Its architecture, a mix of Ionic and Doric columns, has been a source of delight down the ages. The college was the mother of all colleges in Patna University, as it gave birth to numerous famous institutions under its umbrella.
Patna College was really the center of what became a very vibrant intellectual center in India. And if you look at what I would call a kind of an ecosystem which had been created. You had the Patna College, you had the Patna Science College, you had the Engineering College, very famous medical college, which attracted students and faculty from all over India.
Very soon I realized that this is not the place for the average, this is the place for the best. And that was an inspiring moment in my life. That if you have to be here, you have to try to be the best.
The matter of fact was that best of the lot from Bihar, from any better school, they used to join as a student. And among the faculty, topper of the batch used to join as a faculty. So the quality of teaching also, the quality of teacher also, was comparable to any institution in the world to my mind. Yes,
yes, I was a student here. I joined in 1966. And as a teacher, I joined in 1975, and continuously I am teaching in Patna College.
I was coming from an official area. My cognitive world was limited. Patna College acted as a catalytic agent in giving a world view, which was very important.
This institution owes its distinct identity to its response to national and social issues. Illustrious alumni of Patna College like Shri Krishan Singh, Shri Anugrah Narayan Sinha and Shri Jay Prakash Narayan, to name a few, were in the forefront of the freedom movement also. It was here that Patna College alumni Lok Nayak Jay Prakash Narayan first presented his ideas of total revolution in 1974. It soon turned into a nationwide movement, ultimately changing the course of Indian polity.
I could not give that sufficient attention to classes which I was doing initially, because activism in the JP movement, Jail Yatra took a lot of my time. though I wrote my examination and with hard work got a first class.
When the movement started once, because of all this, police came into the campus also, and some of our teachers also received some injuries, like probably the principal also got a stitch or something like that, I think. You see that the bathrooms over there, and the students almost fought a pitched battle for 2 hours, and we used to throw bricks to top of the roof, and from there some students were pelting these stones at the police and all.
The college has been a nursery of great scholars, administrators, patriots, jurists, journalists, lawyers, academics and literators. It has had a great tradition of scholarship, character, and culture of order and discipline. This is a great tribute to the college that it produced the first chief ministers of both Bihar and West Bengal. Much water has flown down the Ganges since the college came into existence. Even today, particularly in the rural society, Patna College continues to symbolize higher education. With an aim to revive the glory of Patna College, the alumni of 1970-72 batch has initiated a campaign to give back to their alma mater.
Giving back something to alma mater is always a it's a high priority. I would want to do whatever one can, and whatever and whenever one is asked, one would be only too happy and too glad to be of any service to the institution, to the great institution that one is so immensely proud of.
I think alumni can play a very positive role, and the time has come for the alumni to become active.
This kind of institution is the biggest asset which can lead to development, which can lead to social change, and the state must do it.
We owe a debt to this institution, and it is our duty to repay that debt.
The Alumni Association in some way can bring the weight of their opinion and their perspective to the decision makers. That would be a very important contribution.
The nostalgia rekindles their will to revive the lost glory of the institution.
Those were nostalgic days, and in fact we got first exposure, of course, in the college, but hostel was another place where we got extreme exposure.
Sunday used to be feast day, because that day there used to be puri and kheer used to be there, so that was feast day. And talking about the mess, we used to get that crisp bhujia. Even our friends from outside who were day scholars, they used to come to the hostel just for that bhujia.
Those were really the golden days of the college, and I remember being taught by such a stalwarts like Professor Ram Charan Sharma, Sayyid Hasan Askari, the doyen of medievalists in Bihar, Professor D.N. Jha, and many more persons.
Our main studies, the honor studies, we really got it from Patna College, and it was a wonderful experience. I had developed an affinity with Patna College, which is there till today.
Un dino women's college mein bahut sare subjects mein honors nahi tha, isliye hum log ladkiyon ko bus mein bheja jata tha Patna College mein padhne ke liye. Us samay ki faculty bhi bahut badhiya thi, bahut mashhoor thi.
Apart from numerous achievers in different spheres of life, the batch of 1970 has produced two union ministers, late Digvijay Singh and Rita Verma. We are also immensely proud of our batchmate, the brave police officer, Martyr Randhir Verma. He was conferred the highest gallantry award of peacetime, the Ashok Chakra.
मेरे पति अपने समय में छात्र भूषण भी रहे थे, तो ये तो स्पोर्ट्स में भी अव्वल थे, सब कुछ में अव्वल ही थे।
I'm so proud of my batch. Our batchmates are so successful that all are shining very brightly in the galaxy of success.
In our endeavor to restore the crowning glory of our alma mater, we deeply miss the presence of our friends whose journey of life was cut short by destiny.
While thinking of Patna College, my thoughts go back to our dear departed friends, friends like Randhir, Ravindra Kishore, Suraj Mishra, Digvijay Dada, whom we fondly called Mitlesh, Harendra, Bhanu. The memory of that time is something which I really cherish, and whenever I recall my old days, I feel that I'm still with them and they're still with us, and I really miss them.
Such was the grandeur of the institution that author E.M. Forster described it in his landmark book, A Passage to India. But today, much of the majesty is lost, as the college has lost much of its shine. Its two popular hostels, Jackson Hostel and Minto Hostel, are in urgent need of restoration.
Now, seeing the condition, rooms dilapidated, no activity, I feel so much disappointed at the time. The collapse, hardly there seems to be any activity. Of course, with the decay of institutions, this has also stopped.
The hostels, you know, both Jackson and Minto hostels, there's a certain history behind them. And if you look at the buildings, if they had been maintained well, if they had been properly kept up, they would have been actually quite pleasant living surroundings.
The apathy of politicians, it is the apathy of the entire, you know, elite class that is governing the country today.
We, the alumni of this great institution, are duty-bound to make the present generation realize what a great legacy they are a part of.
The days of Patna College is always beautiful, momentous. The sheer enormity of the impact which one gets when one enters that campus with a history of more than 100 years would always fascinate us.
My grandfather, whenever he will come and cross Patna College, he will stop the carriage, get down and touch the soil of the gate of Patna College. Because he believed that this is the only institution which has changed Bihar.
The head of the Department of Philosophy, Dr. Professor Dhiran Mohan Dutt, we had one of the greatest historians of the country teaching in the history department, Professor K.K. Dutt, and similarly in other departments.
In our great tradition and culture, any endeavor is incomplete without the blessings of our elders.
I bless the new generation, and I hope my college gets back its old glory.
My college was the premier institution in Bihar, and the premier institution must regain its glory.
Senani karo priyan abhay. भावी इतिहास तुम्हारा है, ये नखत अमा के बुझते हैं, सारा आकाश तुम्हारा है. Let Patna boys listen to this poet.